Without any further ado, please welcome Louis C.K. Come on.
Talk to you for about an hour, and it's weird what I do. Somebody asked me once if it takes confidence to, nobody asked me, but I just want to talk about this. It does take confidence to do this. It takes not a general confidence, but a specific kind, you know? There's lots of kinds of confidence. There's personal confidence. I don't have much of that. Personal confidence is like a man wearing white pants. That takes, you know, tremendous confidence and optimism, really. To leave the house in white pants, like, it's gonna be a great day. It's gonna be no puddles or pizza, nothing. I could never wear white pants, because I'll get my period, first of all, I know that. Or diarrhea, more likely. That's really my period. Diarrhea. About once a month, I'm like, oh, fuck, here we go. Better just get home. And don't make any big decisions today. It's true, don't make, you know, if you have diarrhea, don't like negotiate. It's a bad bargaining position. If I have diarrhea, you stand between me and the toilet, I'll sell you my house for 10 cents. So that's one kind of confidence. Here's another kind, moral confidence. Moral confidence, that means knowing that you would do the right thing, knowing that you wouldn't do something wrong. Moral confidence. You can have that in your daily life, because a lot of your days are the same. But what if you were in another time? Like, I would love to believe, I feel confident that I would not have had slaves. I wouldn't have done it. I wouldn't have had any. Even if I lived in 17 whatever, in Virginia, and all my neighbors had slaves, I would have been like, you guys are dicks. I can say that, but it's easy to say that now, because you can't get no slaves. You just can't, you can't get any. That's why you don't have slaves. It's not because you're better than back then people. It's because they're not available. That's a huge contributing factor. It's not a decision you need to make every day, like you're crying your groceries, but oh, fuck, maybe I should, I don't know, I better not, but geez, it would be easier. Because they're not there. It's not like they have slaves at Home Depot. I mean, they kind of do. But, yeah. There are some forms of kind of slavery. You can get a Russian woman to do whatever you want because her family's hostage. That's one of them. But that's still temporary. I mean, you can adopt, like, a 12-year-old from Bangladesh and... I mean, really, he'll move into your house and do your laundry and suck your dick, whatever you want. But even he gets to leave when he's 18. Although, who wants them when they're that old? I'm just saying, excuse me. I'm just saying that slavery gets rebranded, but it doesn't really ever totally go away. I mean, it's been part of human history going way back, slavery. Even the earliest civilizations in Mesopotamia, I don't know if I didn't go to college, I don't know anything. But the earliest images of human life already had the guys going, ugh, and the guy going, ah, primer, fucker. How early did we come up with this? Like, from the beginning of human existence, we evolved, you know, through ideas. We were a scared naked ape, and then we were like, make a fire, it's a good idea. Kill an animal and take his fur, it's a good idea. Plant things and then wait, it's a good idea. But really quickly we came up with, just make them fucking do it, I'm not doing anything. I'm doing nothing, make them fucking do it. That was like our third thing we did on Earth. So you can have confidence, but you gotta be a little, you know. I mean, there's things that people did in history that I wouldn't have done, for sure. Like, I wouldn't have made an Auschwitz. I wouldn't have done that. What am I gonna do with an Auschwitz? Yeah, Auschwitz is not one of those where you're like, it was the times, you know? It was a horrible thing, obviously. Auschwitz, horrible. They killed people. They killed children. They killed little children in Auschwitz who could have grown up and moved to Brooklyn and hated black people, and they didn't get to do that. It's terrible. I know. I had a friend who's a comedian in England, and he made a joke about Auschwitz, and he got in a lot of trouble. It was a big shitstorm. And at one point, Auschwitz tweeted about his joke. It's true. It's an Auschwitz with a blue check. So I was like, oh, cool, it's really them. You know. And they tweeted like, that's not funny. Why is the death camp tweeting? Who's running the social accounts at Auschwitz? I got a summer job at Auschwitz. I'm running their Twitter.